Good morning, dear students, and welcome back in our biology session. So, in today's session, we are going to start our new lesson from the biology, that is reproduction in animals. Okay. So, in your previous classes, you have learned about the circulatory system, you have learned about the respiratory system, like the different systems you have learned in your previous class, that is in the class 7, and also you have discussed, you have learned about the reproduction in plants. Okay, so in this way you have discussed about the reproduction in the plants, like that the reproduction is also happens in animals. Okay, so in this lesson we are going to see deeply how the reproduction is happens in animals. Okay, but while going to see that, before going to start the lesson, we will discuss about what is mean by reproduction. Is it necessary reproduction? Yes. Okay, so as we know that if there is a birth, then there is a death. Okay, so all the living things are growing, and after the certain period of the time they get death, or they are having the death, they get died. Okay, so because of the die or because of the death, what happened? The number of the species are related to that, the number of the certain species is get decrease. Okay, so again to fulfill that species, again to fulfill the number of that species, the reproduction is important. Okay, so because of the death, certain species on the earth is get decrease, and because of the reproduction, again the that species get fulfilled, or the number of that species get fulfilled on the earth with the help of this reproduction. So this reproduction helps to maintain the different species on the earth. It helps to maintain the survival of the different species on the earth. Also, this reproduction helps for the continuity of the life on the earth. It helps to for the continuous life on the earth, and that is the reason the reproduction is so much important. So what is meant by reproduction? Let's see. The production of new individuals by their parents is called reproduction. Okay, it is called as what? Reproduction. What? The production of new individuals by whom? By their parents is called what? Reproduction. Okay, so the parents are producing the same copy, the exact copy of the newborn or the new individual, and that is only called as what? Reproduction. Okay, so you have seen the so many babies, or you have seen the so many animals baby, we can say that what, if the dog is there, then the you have seen the puppies, that puppy exactly looks like a dog. Also cat is there, then we can say the kittens are there. So like that, different animals are there, and the different animals are having their babies, which we are calling them with the help of the different names. For that, one activity is given in your textbook that you have to complete that table, that is table number 9.1, you have to complete in your textbook. Okay, so different animals are having the different babies, different types of the babies, we can say that, and that babies exactly looks like their parents, and that process is only called as what? Reproduction. So the production, re means what? Again and again production of the new individual, which is the exactly copy of their parents, and that process is called as what? Reproduction. So now we'll discuss about the modes of reproduction. So before going to start the lesson, we have discussed that in the last classes we have discussed about the reproduction in the plants, and that reproduction of the plants are having the two modes of the reproduction, that is what? Sexual reproduction and the sexual reproduction. Same like that, the animals also having the different modes of reproduction, that are sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. Okay, so now let's discuss about what is mean by sexual reproduction. The production of new animal by existing two parents due to the fusion of their gametes is called sexual reproduction. Okay, so in the sexual reproduction, whatever, there is a necessity of the two parents. Okay, and with that parents, what happened? The production of the new animal by the existing of two parents due to the fusion of their gametes. Now gametes means what? The special cells, due to the mixing, due to the fusion of their special cells, and that process is, or that reproduction is called as what? Sexual reproduction. So the new individual is formed due to the mixing, due to the fusion, what we are using here, due to the fusion of the some special cells which are called as what? Gametes, with the help of their two parents, then that process, or then that mode of reproduction, is called as what? Sexual reproduction. Next one, that is what? Asexual reproduction. What happens in the asexual reproduction? The reproduction of new animals by a single parent. Very important. The production of new animals by a single parent without the involvement of gametes. Means in the asexual reproduction, there is no involvement of, there is no any involvement of the gametes, and it is called what? Asexual reproduction. Okay, so these are the two types of the, these are the two modes of the reproduction in the animal, that are sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. So in the sexual reproduction, what happens? There is a fusion of the male and the female gamete. The male and the female gametes get fused with each other, then it forms the zygote. Okay, and from that zygote, the new individual is get formed. Okay, and from that zygote get converted into the new individual. How this exactly happened, that we are going to see in our upcoming sessions. Okay, so this is about what? Sexual reproduction. While in the asexual reproduction, there is no involvement of any gamete, so there is no any fusion of the gametes, and the newborns are the exactly copy of the parents. The sexual reproduction mainly happens in the cow, dog, fish, human beings. Okay, all these are the examples of the, or all these are the different animals, those who are following the sexual mode of reproduction. While the asexual mode of reproduction is followed by the hydra, amoeba. Okay, all these are the organisms, those who are following this asexual mode of reproduction. Okay, so this is all about modes of reproduction. Okay, so just now we have discussed about the modes of reproduction. So among the mode of the reproduction, first we will discuss about the sexual reproduction. So let's discuss about the first mode of the reproduction, that is what? Sexual reproduction in deeply. Most of the animals are following the sexual modes of reproduction, and as we know that in the sexual mode of the reproduction, the two parents involved, that is one is male and another one is female. So that male and the female, both the parents are having the different reproductive organ, and also they are having the different gametes also. So the adult male produces the gamete, and that gametes are called as what? Sperms. While the adult female produces the gametes, which are called as ova, or singularly it is called as what? Ovum or eggs. Okay, so the sperms and the ova or the eggs, these are the male and the female gametes respectively, which are get produced in the male and the female's body. Okay, so the production of the process of production of gametes is called gametogenesis. Okay, so the production of the gametes in the body of animals, that process is called as what? Gametogenesis. Okay, and the male gametes is called as sperms, while the female gametes is called as ova or eggs. Okay, so this is about what? Gametes. And the process of production of gametes is called as what? Gametogenesis. Now we will move for the next point, that is nothing but what? Fertilization. So what is mean by the, what is mean by the fertilization? Let's discuss first. The fusion of a male gametes, that is what? Sperms, with a female gamete, that is what? Ovum, to form zygote during sexual reproduction is called fertilization. Okay, so the fusion of the male and
and the female gamete during the sexual reproduction, it is called as what? Fertilization. The fusion of male gametes, which is the male gamete, that is sperms, with a female gamete, what is the female gamete, that is what? Ovum, to form a zygote during sexual reproduction is called what? Fertilization. Okay, zygote is the fertilized egg and it is the first cell in the newborn baby or new individual. So the zygote is the first cell in new individual. As we have discussed now that the fusion of the male and the female gametes is called as what? Fertilization. So that fertilization of the egg is happen inside the body of the female or the outside the body of the female also. So on the basis of that, the fertilization are of two types, that are external fertilization and internal fertilization. So let's discuss about what is meant by external fertilization and the internal fertilization. First we'll discuss about the external fertilization. From the name only we'll come to know that external means what? The fertilization which happens outside the body of female. Okay, so let's see the fertilization that occurs outside the female's body is called external fertilization. Okay, so the fertilization that occurs external or the outside the body of female, that fertilization is called as what? External fertilization. So this external fertilization mainly happens in the amphibians like a frog and toad, and also it happens in the fish also. So the female amphibians or the female fish lays a thousands or the hundred of the eggs in the water during the rainy season. So during the rainy season they move towards the ponds or the low running water area, and they lays their thousands of the eggs, or they lays their the group of the eggs, and that group of the eggs is get covered with the jelly like substance. The jelly like substance helps to protect the egg, and also it holds the eggs together. Okay, so the eggs get formed and it get released into the water also. And after that, if the eggs are there, then the fertilization is also important. So for the fertilization, sperms are also necessary. So what happens, that male releases us thousands of the sperms in the water, and the sperms are having a tail. So with the help of that tail, the sperms can easily run in the water and they get randomly spread everywhere in the water, and when that sperms comes in the contact of the eggs, then the eggs get fertilized. Okay, so here what we have discussed, that fertilization happens with the help of the eggs and the sperms, but where it happens? Outside the body of female, and that is the reason it is called as what? External fertilization. So this is about what? External fertilization. Now we will discuss about the next mode of the next type of the fertilization, that is what? Internal fertilization. What is meant by internal fertilization? The fertilization that occurs inside the female's body is called internal fertilization. Okay, so the fertilization which occurs inside the female's body, that fertilization is called as what? Internal fertilization. So in this internal fertilization, what happens? The eggs are get fertilized inside the body of female. In this type of the fertilization, what happens? The eggs are get fertilized by the sperms inside the female's body to form zygote. Okay, so the fertilization is happen inside the female's body to form zygote. In this case or in this type of the fertilization, the male animal releases the sperms in the body of the female animals. The sperms which are released by the male animal move towards the eggs, and the eggs is get fertilized inside the body of female, and that is only we are calling as what? Internal fertilization. So this internal fertilization ऑर्गनाइजेशन मेनली टेक्स प्लेस इन द एनिमल्स लाइक मैमल्स. ऑल द मैमल्स आर डूइंग द रिप्रोडक्शन विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस इंटरनल फर्टिलाइजेशन इंक्लूडिंग ह्यूमन बींग्स ऑल्सो. सो बर्ड्स, रेप्टाइल्स एंड इंसेक्ट्स आर ऑल्सो फॉलोइंग दिस इंटरनल मोड ऑफ द फर्टिलाइजेशन. ओके, सो दीज आर द टू वेज ऑफ द फर्टिलाइजेशन, दैट इज वॉट एक्सटर्नल फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड इंटरनल फर्टिलाइजेशन. ओके, नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ओविपोरस एंड द विविपोरस दैट यू हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इन योर सम प्रीवियस क्लासेस. सो नाउ लेट डिस्कस अबाउट द विविपोरस एंड द ओविपोरस. वॉट इज मीन बाय विविपोरस एंड द ओविपोरस? सो सी हियर, जस्ट नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द इंटरनल एंड द एक्सटर्नल फर्टिलाइजेशन. सो द ह्यूमन बींग्स एंड द हेन बोथ आर हैविंग द इंटरनल फर्टिलाइजेशन, बट द ह्यूमन बींग्स आर गिविंग द बर्थ टू द बेबी डिरेक्टली वाइल द हेन इज गिविंग द बर्थ टू देयर बेबीज विद द हेल्प ऑफ द eggs. Okay, so see here, the animals, those who are giving the birth to their young ones directly, that animals are called as what? Viviparous animals. That animals are called as what? Viviparous animals. For example, we can say that cow, dog, buffalo is there, human beings are there, so many mammals are there, they are called as what? Viviparous animals. First one, we have discussed about the hen. So the hens are first internal fertilization is happened, and then the hen is giving the eggs, and from that eggs, after the certain period of the time, the chicks comes out. Okay, so that is what the animals, those who are laying the eggs, and from that eggs their newborn babies comes out. That animals are called as what? Oviparous animals. The animals, those who are laying the egg, and from that eggs their newborns babies are comes out, or their babies comes out, then that animals are called as what? Oviparous animals. It is very easy to keep in the mind. Viviparous means what? To give directly birth. And the oviparous, O is there, how is the shape of the egg? Like a oval shape. So in this way you can keep in the mind, oval shape, that is what? Oviparous, which gives the egg, and from that eggs the newborn babies are coming out. While the viviparous means what? Those who are giving directly birth to their young ones. Okay, so this is all about today. We have discussed about the fertilization, different types of the fertilization, also we have discussed about the viviparous and the oviparous. Okay, so this is all about today. This is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video with the next point. Till then, goodbye.